First day of summer, we are putting the last of our fertilizer down before we start on the grass. Once we've cut the grass and got some hay, we can buy ourselves some animals. Which we are looking forward to getting. We won't get any manure until autumn when the wheat and barley are ready. First field we cook will be baled. We've got a lovely summer coming up. Weather forecast looks like it's going to be nice and sunny all summer. Well, the first 8 days of summer look like we've got lovely weather, so we can get the hay cut. Carted to the yard and stored up without losing anything out of the bales due to the weather. May well also hire ourselves a bale wrapper and get some silage made. Again, can't get total mixed ration until we start the harvest, but gives us time to get the silage ready before the onset of autumn. We'll take much of the summer to ferment down. Plenty of time at the moment to get things sorted on that. This John Deere 6810 doing a great job fertilising the field. It's now popped to field 6. It's only a small field, once around the field and done in there. Potato field as well to do, which is opposite side of the road to this one. Plenty of fertiliser left in, so we can hopefully get the potatoes and this field finished. Spread on this and only a small field. So we've got around here and back down to the top of the field with this one done very quickly. Should this last stage of fertiliser on, get a good crop. A bit tight around here where the potato field is, a good struggle getting the potato harvester in and working, but should be okay, I think. Left enough with the headland and the gap between the headland and the main rows. Should have left enough room to get turned around. Did get the little sugar beet field done before we came into the blog. Field to do now, field 7 and the one up near the pig yard as well. potatoes do look nice, they're coming through lovely, so go through here, I should get it. It's got it lovely, so one more breed back and that's got this field finished. Probably got another breed after this one, I'm not sure yet, we'll have a look. It's going to do it, just a little thin strip, but it's a waste of fertiliser to excuse me, waste of fertiliser to do that little breed. Because it's like two rows of potatoes and we'll be spreading 20 or 30 rows that we've already done. So not cost effective, especially in this first season for us to do that piece. This main road is usually busy, no cars here at the moment, so got out easily enough. Not much traffic at all today. Probably another half an hour and we'll get the rush hour. I think we've missed that. Headland in there. This crop getting fairly tall now, so it's a good job we've come in today to do it. Otherwise we'd have had it brushing on the bottom of the tractor and spoiling the rapeseed. The grass growing through just here, didn't get it all out when we ploughed. So, there's one field left to fertilise after this one. Reason got a problem and we're down to 2 frames a second, so that, bear with us, the GoPro will pick up again. Now around the headlands. Just come back up to the top. And our tram lines, now we can through. This is the last breed in this field again, so quickly getting through fertilizing. So head down to our last field. That's the biggest field we own at the moment, the next field, so take a little bit longer to get through it. Is that field done? Traffic started to build now. Most people who are not in farming tend to start work. Cows or anything, could get a loan out. Should produce enough milk once we get into autumn and the straw goes in, and get full production on the cows. Should then pay for the loan until we get it paid off, pay the interest off, no problems. Without a loan on our backs, but it will save money on fertilizer and have an income coming in, so it'd be a good investment. I'm sure the bank, when I go talk to them, will see the potential of the farm. We haven't got a lot of land at the moment. They loaned us some money to get the farm back out of receivership. We took the farm over from my grandfather, although we couldn't afford to buy the whole of the estate. As I said before, the plan is get the farm back to what it used to be and own all what you see around us. How many years it will take to get all the land back that was originally on the farm, I don't know. Breeds in here, we'll get this finished, and as we head to the yard, that's where we will leave you for today. Should have enough fertiliser in the tank to finish this. Growing. We had a few wet days not long after we planted, so it's now with the warm weather and the rain it's had, it's really picked up. breeds after this, I think. Should be to the end of fertilizing for this season. Although it's nice sunny weather today at the moment, it's still only 8 degrees. Mind you, we're still at 8 o'clock in the morning, so I'd imagine the temperature will increase shortly to make for good haymaking weather. So it's going to be 21 degrees tomorrow, 22 on Thursday, so we will quickly dry out the grass. Cut and ted the field on one plug and then come back and row it up and bale it in the next. And we can cart the bales and then head to the next field and do much the same again. The way the weather is, we've got no rush to collect the bales and get them in the yard. Pop this fertilizer spreader down to the pig farm, leave it there, and the tractor will be in the pig farm ready for collecting up the grass mower. That's got all our fertilizing done. Many fields, it's pretty easy to get it finished in a day. So it really didn't have to start so early in the morning, but at least we can get day. We can do some maintenance work around the yard. We'd have a bit of rough wind. You saw us clearing the wood up in the vicarage there. It's got us a bit of money in. We may actually, there is one tree I noticed wasn't safe. So we may well go to the vicarage and see if he wants that one chopping down. So just get some money for some cows. Put this in here, and as we're dropping this off, we will finish the blog. So, thank you for watching. Please give it a like, give it a share. If you are new to the channel and want to see more of the work we do here, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification icon, tell you when the videos are uploaded, when we do our live streams, when I do these vlogs that go on to the Summer Farm Estates channel. Until next time, this is John Greenway, so thank you for watching, goodbye for now.